Absolutely. Shalom. All praises to Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. We'll give double. You going over there too? Double honor to the apostles, the great millstone. We out here in Columbus, Ohio. We the real Israelites, the only authorized Israelites in Columbus, authorized by the Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai to be teaching. The IUIC is not authorized. Oh yeah, cause I just had, they be out here teaching too sometimes, right? And it was, they just some assholes. They're a bunch of dumbasses. They got no truth. But they ain't got no mercy, you know what I'm saying? That's their problem. But I got a scripture for it. You got anything y'all want to do?
Yeah, I got something, bro. We're right in the spirit right now. You know, talking about these false ass prophets. I got a, this is Ezekiel 13:1. And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, prophesy against the prophets of Israel that prophesy, and say thou unto them that prophesy out of their own hearts, hear ye the word of the Lord.
You know what? When you have it, you're going to look at Chinese, Indian, black, white,
we're the 12 tribes of Israel.
Oh, yeah,
that's us.
Just expecting
that,
Lord.
Yeah,
anytime.
You're
an
Israelite.
Yeah, that's the 12 tribes of Israel.
In America, it's great because see, you have an eye like me. You have a heart, soul. So it's a big people. People's people.
12 tribes of Israel.
Yeah, that's the 12 tribes of Israel. Because Esau is not a person. He's a devil. And he doesn't have a heart like you and me. Yeah, his heart's fucking cold as ice. You know what I'm saying? He's a devil. And his mouth is full of poison. Go ahead.
Son of man, prophesy against the prophets of Israel that prophesy, and say thou unto them that prophesy out of their own hearts, hear ye the word of the Lord. You hear when they out here speaking, just the very vibration that they put. You know, you listen to him, you know, the reader, man. He sounds like a more of an actor. It's reading.
Yeah, they act.
It ain't his voice, you know?
They just trying to sound good.
Mm-hmm. And it end up sounding foolish.
They thinking they just want to look good in the sight of men. But like, yeah, like I said, they got no mercy. Like, you supposed to be out here showing mercy to people, trying to teach these people, man. Because they don't know no better. But somebody told me they was like cursing out a homeless dude because he had long hair. I mean, like, everything you could have got on him. Of course you ain't supposed to have long hair, right? But here, this dude homeless, probably can't afford a haircut. But they just think they better than everybody, you know what I'm saying? Here it is, they cussing out somebody for having long hair. But them dudes, they got zigzags, they got fades. You know what I'm saying? You ain't supposed to be getting edge up. They all got edge ups. Ain't none of them got no beards, you know what I'm saying? If they got a beard, it's all lined up, zigzagged up in there. So them dudes are hypocrites, man.
Just let me hear the rolling cool fucking thing. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
It's
all right. Let me hear something.
They gonna be justified and condemned by their own words. You condemn yourself with your own tongue when you come against the Lord. Go ahead.
I don't know if they're just mad because we don't.
They just mad because they like, they got that little girl spirit on them. That little effeminate, little weak spirit, but they afraid to speak up against anything. That little slave mentality. Yeah, people got a slave mentality. You know what I'm saying? That's what the Bible says. It said, yeah, boy, you in there, what?
His mouth got stitches, like, you know, tattoo stitches.
Gone, man.
You know, that's just spiritual. Ain't shit coming out of his mouth that's gonna make sense.
Yeah, the Lord sewed his mouth up.
Right. Thus saith the Lord power, woe unto the foolish prophets that follow their own spirit and have seen nothing.
Yeah, that's the IUIC. Hey, that's all these people be out here, man. All them preachers and them churches. They be making us some wild, whacked out prophecies. Talking about the Antichrist is going to come and rebuild the temple in Jerusalem. And they just making up some bugged out prophecies. You know what I'm saying? Don't. Go ahead.
Here, Nate, don't see the. Oh, my back, man. Go ahead. they didn't see that they saw a new kingdom. The new kingdom of them uniting Israel together, building all these new churches and shit they building, man.
They think, you know, the kingdom is in America.
Right.
The kingdom is not going to be in America. You know what's going to be in America? Ashes, rocks, dirt. You know what I'm saying?
The smell of smoke.
Yeah, sulfur. Yeah, the smell of smoke. Smoke rising. You know what I'm saying?
What was you saying?
I heard that girls are saying you can't get married until you're like 2 years old.
Yeah.
They told her that.
That's crazy.
White hair, bitch.
Yeah. The scriptures don't say that. By the time a woman's 20 years old, she done been had sex with 1,000 dudes. Don't nobody even want that by the time she's 20, bro. Because back in the ancient world, a lot of times marriages were just arranged anyway. You know what I mean? Yeah, a woman didn't even have a choice. Her father would make the best decision for her. Because a woman really don't know what's good for herself. That's why she gets with a man like, I don't really like him no more. And then she gets with a new dude and another dude and another dude. And then she's polluted and defiled.
Polluted. What's that old girl? What's her name? Sarah and Tobin? Who was promised to Tobin.
Yeah, was promised to Tobin. Tobin's son.
Tobias.
The son. And it says she was chosen for him before the earth was created. So, yeah, that was bugged out.
Everybody else was trying to marry her as an adult.
Because she didn't belong to them.
That's right. Spirit of the Lord powerful, man.
Yep.
Powerful.
Yeah, because if the Lord really wants you to have a certain woman, he's going to give her to you.
That's right. Let me continue on. They have seen vanity and lying divinations, saying, the Lord saith, and the Lord hath not sent them.
Oh, that was a lying divination. When a preacher said when Donald Trump was inaugurated, it was raining, and he said that was a blessing from the Most High.
It started raining.
That's a lying divination. And then now you got Donald Trump, and they keep invoking God in all of his speeches, saying God bless America, and God this, and God is going to bless us. You keep invoking the Most High. You gonna have to pay the consequences for that. At least Obama was smart enough to stay away from that. You know what I mean? You gonna have to pay for that. Because everything they're doing is ungodly.
Then nobody questions which God they serve in.
Yeah, because you know, they didn't ask it. They didn't say a name, did they?
We know what God they serve.
It's Satan. They worship Satan.
Saying the Lord saith, and the Lord hath not sent them, and they have made others to hope that they will confirm the word. Have ye not seen a vain vision, and have ye not spoken a lying divination?
Oh yeah, so when people saying, yeah, America is going, we're going to save America, America is going to be rebuilt, you know what I'm saying? That's a vain vision, that's a false vision, that's a lying vision.
Israel unite.
Yeah, Israel unite. You got IUIC marching in formation, walking down the street, wearing purple uniforms, running, looking like clowns. Looking like straight up clowns, you know what I'm saying?
You got me fucked up.
They trying to follow Esau's system.
Running drills, man.
And that's why when we see IUIC out here, they're run from us, man. They won't even talk to us. Because they know they ain't got no answers. We're going to ask them a question, and they ain't going to have the answer. And soon they're going to have to report to the Lord.
From the other side, take some pictures.
When they was on the corner. Yeah, right.
They was probably taking pictures for Nathaniel's probably making a dossier on us, you know what I mean? Reporting us to the authorities.
Yeah. Pictures they take have curses on
it. And how you gonna have an Israelite group where the head of your group is part of the NYPD?
You know he can't pick up all the ones that's in the different cities and shit. That's probably all part of this cop scheme.
Yes, it is! Thank you! Thank you! Caesar Longoria, that fucking asshole!
It looks like Red Man. He just said something about fuck all you crackers. Hey, Lord made his ass a wild ass spirit, you know what I mean? He might do
it.
The Lord gonna put the spirit on him.
Huh?
Right. Yeah. So you believe in the Bible?
No, I don't.
Are you a proud atheist?
I'm not really proud.
You're so crazy.
Yeah, you're crazy.
No, sir, just what I believe.
You're so crazy. She said it's proud as hell, didn't she?
Yeah.
That's the devil for
that
you.
That a derpy ass voice.
That's the devil for you.
I'm not proud. Sound like a damn cartoon character.
They laugh at y'all, man.
Wow, that's good, because the Lord gonna laugh at them too.
Oh, let me get that scripture.
You going to Proverbs or yeah, check this out.
Go ahead.
What scripture is that laughing at your ass, man?
Hold on, let me read.
No, what scripture is that?
I'm about to read it.
In Corinthians it said we was made fools.
No. We ain't laughing.
No, we got a scripture where the Lord gonna laugh at them. We the only one out here that have the cohank. How you say that word? We the only ones that got the balls to come out here. It don't matter, bro. I can't pronounce a lot of words. I can barely speak English. Like, I give a goddamn. I don't give a damn. I'm rude in speech, bro. I'm going to talk and talk a whole lot, and I'm going to talk loud.
Listen, my man. Listen. This is Proverbs 1:25. It says, "But ye have set at naught all my counsel, and with none of my reproof, we come out here to tell the people to repent from their wicked ways," right?
All
right,
bitch.
Like you say, they laugh at us, they make mockery at us, they scoff against us, which is only 2 Peter 3,
Basically
last day scoffer. Listen, my man, ain't none of that stuff important, man. It's all scripture. The Lord is important, right? Right? Listen, my man, listen. They all want to continue to do all their wickedness. Right, I know. We, you know, but that's why we love it, man. That fuels us.
Okay,
nah, we don't need none of that. The Lord said, 58:1, Isaiah 58:1, to lift up thy voice like a trumpet. Pretty much he's saying, in other words, come out here and be a man. And only a man's going to speak in his high tongue. You know, only a man is going to speak in a manner.
You don't need none of that.
You got to get up. You got to get a permit to come out here with speaking.
Y'all in that group yet?
Nah, we out here to condemn them.
Huh? Hold on, man.
We out here to condemn them. But listen, let me finish this before we move on to something else. But ye have said it in all my counsel. Listen, my man.
Your beards and oils.
Beards.
You know, guys got the beards.
Beards. I can't grow a beard. That's all I can
do. I got the red and all that.
Don't
act like you're the one, bro.
Yeah, we out here to condemn them.
You are?
Yeah, because they're doing the work deceitfully. They come out here looking fly and flashy, but they come out here to do the work deceitfully.
They look fly and flashy now, ain't flashy.
Well, you know, in most people's eyes, that shit is...
So Nathaniel, the head of Nathaniel's group, he's a detective for the NYPD. You gonna follow them?
Hey, listen.
A detective?
I ain't got no problem.
A detective.
I ain't got no problem.
The detective.
I'm just me, man.
The police.
I did my time, man.
What you trying for?
Shit. You go.
So that means
you did the police.
Not enough.
You want more?
No more. Bro, I ain't did nothing in 2025.
You must have been. They had me locked up.
No, I'm saying my.
Hey, listen, my man. But ye have said it, no, all my counsel with none of my proof. Listen. I also will laugh at your calamity.
That's you.
Could be him too.
That's you, Tom.
That's anybody that ain't listening. That's anybody that ain't listening.
Anybody don't listen to me.
That's anybody that ain't listening.
What is wrong with people? on.
I just wanted to be on camera.
Oh, there you go.
You want to strip on camera?
We're going to vine that one.
No. It'll be warm next week. You'll be able to strip then. Let me stay on this, man. I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. You know?
Like your boy came up, yeah, like, oh. He making fun of me because I can't talk right. I make fun of myself because I can't talk right. You know what I'm saying? Moses couldn't talk right. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
They said Moses had a stammering tongue. You know? Yeah. Can't none of y'all speak right either. Most of y'all got about a vocabulary of 50 words. Y'all use fuck for like all your adjectives and verbs.
Ebonics.
Yeah, Ebonics. Talking about we can't talk. I'm like we're like geniuses compared to these people.
And the people in England actually talking right.
Oh, they talk right. Way better than us. I watch some brothers in England speaking. I'm like, man, these guys right here, they sound like they got some education.
Yeah,
that's just because it's a different environment.
They get a beautiful spot to be teaching.
That's got to be good. America's the dirty, dirty. You know what I'm saying? We all raised up as heathens over here. You know what I mean?
Marshall, bring it out for education camera
stick. Yeah.
2 Peter 3:3. Knowing this first, that there shall come in the last day scoffers walking at their own lust.
What did he say? You can't talk. You can't even pronounce. What did he say? I couldn't even
say. Yeah.
I couldn't hardly understand what he was saying. Yeah. Shit, you know? I mean, it's just a good another time.
He said they laughing at you.
Good.
They're all slaves. They're all in slavery. They're all slaves. They're all broke as hell, riding the coat of us, laughing at us. Okay. Well, y'all in slavery. Y'all ain't got shit. You know what I'm saying? You ain't in a position to laugh at nobody. You know what I'm saying? This devil can roll up on y'all, do anything he wants to you. A cop can roll up on you right now, blow your brains out, and there's nothing you could do about it. Your family ain't gonna do nothing about it, and y'all just gonna sit and take it. We all gonna laugh at us. They ain't laughing when your ass is in the back of the cruiser or laid out with your goddamn brains on the ground looking like a fucking splattered egg. You know what I'm saying? Then y'all wanna protest and cry. You know what I'm saying? They shot my baby!
First of all, the Lord said, I should go no more back y'all into a corner again. Shit gonna happen to us out here.
For real.
You know what I'm saying? We protected under that name, man.
For real.
You know? I got it's from Joe 22 and Ashley.
Which were cut down out of time, whose foundation was overflowing with flood, which God said unto instead of to God, the parking lot, what can the Almighty do? When you build the house of the wicked, with the counsel of the wicked fall from you. The righteous see it and are glad, and it is their last and their scorn.
Yeah, oh, that's a good one.
That's nice.
Hey, read that again.
It says Job 22:19, the righteous see it and are glad, and the innocent laugh them to scorn.
Mm. That's right. Yeah. So it ain't like we're gonna be out here praying for these motherfuckers when the trouble start either, you know? The words of Jeremiah say, pray not thou for these people.
Yeah. Lift up not a cry for them.
Right. So soon.
So soon they got soon. They laughing at us now. Soon they gonna be crying, man.
It's all common sense.
Yeah, what y'all gonna do when Donald Trump send them feds in to clean them streets up? He gonna send them feds in. What y'all gonna do then? Y'all gonna laugh then, right? You're gonna laugh then, right? Okay.
Yeah, it's coming. I got some more of this, man. This is me, man. This problem is only. I'm just trying to keep my fingers moving for a second.
I'll read this one. Psalms 2:1. Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel together against Yahweh and against his anointed, saying, who's the Lord's anointed? That's what the word Christ means, anointed. You know what I'm saying?
Who? The ones that's calling on his name.
Yeah, exactly. Because really in Hebrew is Mashiach. Okay? That's the anointed. And the anointed ones is the Israelites. And that we're the Israelites. We was anointed. Said, let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. Because right now, we got bands on us. You know what I'm saying? We in slavery out here. We being oppressed. America is the kingdom of Satan, okay? This is not a nice place to live. It's not a good place to raise your children. You don't have children in America. In America, your children belong to the state. In America, you're just a number. You're not a person. To the government, you're a number. You're just another statistic, you know what I mean? Just like a cattle, you brand the cattle. Oh, this is the cow number 145. You know what I'm saying? You're just an animal. You're lower than an animal. Say, he that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. Yahweh shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex them in his sore displeasure. So it said, he that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. He going to vex him in his sore displeasure.
Can you imagine, man, you hungry as fuck? You know, the kids is crying, they hungry as fuck. And he also vexing you too? On top of all that, man? Most high bad, man. King of terror, man. King of terror, man. Ain't nothing like having a fucked up day, man, and you broke as fuck. You lost your job, man. Your woman just left you for another nigga, you know, for a heathen. You know, he gonna vex these motherfuckers. Fuck these people, man.
Yeah, these people ain't shit.
They gonna deserve everything that's gonna happen.
They're the problem. They are the problem. They are the problem. The reason this shit is like this is because of these people. These wicked ass Israelites out here. They don't want to follow the ways of the Lord. They want to follow the ways of the heathens. Go ahead.
Here you go. When your fear cometh as a desolation, and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer.
Yeah, that's how they always do it. They don't want to call upon the name of the, they don't even know the name of the Lord to begin with, but they want to pray to sweet Jesus when they get in some trouble. When their little baby got shot, or they get, you know what I mean? Jesus. Talking about, will you pray for my baby? Well, you know, the baby is 18 years old. He's a fucking,
right, grown ass man.
A big piece of shit, you know what I mean? Man. A drug dealer. Right. And they want some prayers for him because he got shot over some dope money or something.
Right. I'm praying the Lord vex him some more. That's my prayers.
These motherfuckers, man. He done jacked Lord knows how many people, and you want us to pray for him.
My baby, my baby, my baby. When distress and anguish cometh upon you, then they shall call upon me, but I would not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. For that they hated knowledge.
Yeah, these people hate knowledge, man. You try to teach them, they get disgusted. That's why you do is like, you know what I'm saying? That's why they laughing at you. And he thought it was funny, you know what I mean? Old demon. He's an old demon.
You don't want to listen to the scripture or nothing.
Yeah, he tried reading the scripture, he turning his head, can't pay attention.
That's the Most High doing that, man.
That is the Most High. We see that all the time.
Turn your head. You just started reading. Listen, man, listen. All right, I'm listening.
We
you
might
start reading.
From now on, when somebody starts doing that, we might as well just stop. You know what I mean? Because they're not going to listen.
Well, we got to put it in. We got to nail it in. That's just showing them on camera that these motherfuckers can care less about
it. They don't. They just don't listen. It's the last thing on their mind.
Oh, my goodness, man. Can you see what's going to come, man?
But they so worried.
Imagine it, man.
But they be worried about us being out here, don't they? It bothers them.
Yeah, it
vexes them. Why does it vex you so bad?
Right.
It vexes us that y'all out here.
Yeah. It vexes them. It condemns them. For that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. They would none of my counsel. They despised all my reproof. Therefore shall they eat of the fruit of their own way and be filled with their own devices. For the turning away of the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of fools shall destroy them. But whosoever hearkens to me shall
prosper. The prosperity of fools. So what's the prosperity of a fool? What kind of prosperity is that? You got no wisdom, no knowledge, no fear of the Lord. That's why you out here. That's why you a fucking slave.
Spiritual food.
That's why you ain't got shit. That's why your house is filled with roaches and shit. You know what I'm saying? That's why your fucking, your baby's mama gave you AIDS.
That's why your baby's mama gave
you AIDS. Exactly. You out there licking it out.
You ate it out.
You ate it out.
right in cold lake, lips and mouth got perfect pink.
Y'all, y'all showed up.
Woke up, your lips is glowing in the dark. Shit. Oh, shit.
These raggedy ass people, man.
Why we should make a sign, man. Motherfuckers that call these venereal diseases from alcoholic adultery.
Yeah.
What's up, brother?
What's up, bro? Yeah, that, cause if nobody committed adultery, I mean, common damn sense tells you there'd be no diseases. I mean, this shit's just common sense shit,
There'd be none.
Get rid of the faggots and adulterers, you got yourselves a healthy society. But that makes too much fucking sense. You know what I'm saying? Hey, but the prosperity of a fool, though. The prosperity of a fool is what? Oh, you got herpes. You got warts. No, that's the prosperity of a fool.
She got warts.
Yeah, these beautiful, you see these women, they be beautiful on the outside, right? Hey, but they got all these venereal diseases. Because they so beautiful, every last time Dick and Harry went up in it. Go ahead.
Isaiah 33:14, the sinners in Zion are afraid, fearfulness shall surprise the hypocrite. Who among them shall dwell in the belly fire, the burning fire? Who among them shall dwell in the everlasting burning? Isaiah 33:14, the sinners in Zion are afraid, fearfulness hath surprised the hypocrite. Who among them shall dwell in the burning fire? Who among them shall dwell in the everlasting burning?
Yeah. They are hypocrites, and they're going to get stuck with that fear. They're
going to learn fear, huh?
They're going to learn to be afraid.
North Highland is that way road.
By that time, that fear ain't going to be lifted up off of them. You know, just like Most High give us hard time every once in a while. He give us a little rest from that hard time every once in a while. It ain't going to lift off of these people, man. You know, that's what we're waiting for. That's what we're praying for to happen in the 18th century. Look at that shit, man. I don't even want to be in the 18th century. I don't even care, man.
That's just trifling. That's backwards. Man, these people are backwards as hell. They trifling as hell. Retarded as hell.
This is all meat, man. I don't know where this is.
Might as well just read it up.
Read it.
I like some reading.
Meat. This is just beautiful, man. Out of this book, it condemns the shit out of goddamn. This is amazing.
Hey, motherfucker.
It's amazing, man.
What the fuck is that?
Yeah, right.
Man, these people's gone, man.
They in need of a savior, man. Very few of them understand they in need of a savior, man. But most of them, man, they ain't in need of none. They ain't in need of
a
welfare check. They in need of a social security check or something like that, man. You know what I'm saying? They in need of their next hit or lick or next high or whatever. So they ain't in need of no savior, man. So since they don't need Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, he don't need them either.
I need a savior. I got to get the fuck out of here.
Immediately.
I ain't trying to stay here no more.
No more, man. We wanted out of here yesterday, man.
I want out.
Please,
let me out.
Please release us off these
chains.
It's
just like when I was in jail. It's like, let me out.
Yeah, right.
Can I please get the fuck out of here?
Right. Going out.
This shit's a fucking nightmare.
Right. Same shit. Being locked up behind bars.
It's the same shit. It is the same shit.
Same shit.
I can check my phone out here.
Ooh.
Wow.
Same shit. Captivity. Here we go. This is Jeremiah 7 and 8. Behold, ye trust in lying words that cannot profit. Will ye steal, murder, and commit adultery and swear falsely?
And right, yeah, and adultery, that's heavy. That's the heaviest sin out here, man, is adultery. And like we always say, in America, there's no punishment for adultery. Mm. You know, one of the Ten Commandments, adultery, and it's legal in America. A woman can commit adultery on you and get rewarded, get child support, take your ass to court, get you locked up. And that's one of the Ten Commandments. So this country got no respect for the laws of the Lord. That's why the Lord is going to destroy this country. Okay, Donald Trump ain't going to save no America. It's going to be destroyed.
That's
why we're doing the work of Lord crying to the Lord. Because we doing bad. You know what I'm saying? Because we doing bad. But teaching me. You know what? You're a Israelite, man. That's your natural.
It ain't a choice.
Just fuck me up with that, man.
What is it?
So we were living next to them. Being scattered, we took them all kind of other names to go, man. We're Israelites.
We derived from out of Canada.
What's up, brother?
Hey, man. That's Canada.
It's all representation, you know what I'm saying? You gotta understand the culture. My mom got to know the representation of that, what it means, what it's for.
How you say it in Hebrew? It's Yahshua Allah. Israel's an anglicized form of the word, which is totally off, actually.
Hell no.
It's totally different. It's not even spelled the same way. You know what I'm saying? It's totally different, bro. That's that old.
Israel.
And it's not even L, it's pronounced Allah.
And it's speak English,
it's spoken Hebrew. It's
spoken Hebrew. I understand it.
You
know Allah El Shalah Hamashiach. That's not Hebrew. I speak
that. That's that L. It's not pronounced L, it's Allah. That's why the Muslims call God Allah, that's Hebrew.
So that
L,
the Muslims also call God a lot, which symbolizes as a female understanding, a female God.
That's right. This is Romans 7:24. For we are saved by hope. The hope that is seen is not hope.
Ain't no hope in Egypt.
So you ain't got to fist me down something, fist me in front of you. You know what I'm saying? The Lord only dealing with people. As a matter of fact, hope, that hope and faith is a gift that the Heavenly Father actually gives to you. But people that don't have no faith and hope, they got to physically have something right there in the midst of them to believe. You know what I'm saying? So ain't gonna be no archaeological digs that we can pull out. This is Moses. Moses existed.
And first of all, they can't even do digs in Jerusalem because
why don't they have adequate tools for any one of those kings?
Well, they did have the money, but the devil
say tongues.
The devil brought them on.
They don't have any adequate tools.
Let me ask you a question. Where's Alexander the Great tomb? They ain't found it. He never existed.
Right.
Where's Genghis Khan's
tomb? But he's written on the history books, though.
Oh, yeah, he's in the books, though. Where's Genghis Khan's tomb?
I'm pretty sure Genghis Khan exists.
Where's his tomb?
He didn't exist. Alexander.
Where's his tomb at?
I'm not so sure about Alexander.
But where's his tomb?
He was the Macedonian.
You're right. You know a little something. But where's their tomb at, though?
Where's the proof?
I got half physical
proof.
They had his name on artifacts on the Moabite stone.
You ever hear about the Moabite stone? And it speaks about the house of the water.
I heard about it. Recognize all the knowledge of what's going on in the books, you realize that nobody existed. No man existed.
That's why the Lord said the Holy Spirit.
When you look at Jesus.
When the Romans came through and burnt down Jerusalem, they burnt down an imaginary city, right? In 70 AD, when they stole the seven candlesticks.
You gotta humble yourself and throw garbage away, man. You gotta learn it. You gotta start off.
So who was the Romans fighting?
You look at Jesus.
You just can't name it. I won a motherfucking award, man. Hey, I won one. I just rushed for 300 yards in the Super Bowl, most valuable player. I don't want you making up a new name when I get all my face all across this TV screen. You give me another name. You just name me somebody
Michael
else.
Michael Jordan. That's a Hebrew.
Albert Jordan. Hold on, what Albert is?
I don't know. I know a guy named Albert.
That name popped in my head, but.
That name is put in the Bible for a stone.
I understand, but where was it derived from?
Yahweh.
Amen.
You know what?
It came from God very hot.
Let me finish reading. But hope that is seen is not hope. For what a man sees, why does he get hope for?
You guys have to highlight.
But if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it. So that's a gift that the Lord is only going to give to a certain amount of small amount of people.
St. John chapter 10, verse 33.
Faith and hope.
What does that say?
Hold on, let me finish this.
Oh, yeah, he got something right here. Oh, yeah, the Tell David script. They talk about King David on that. You know what I'm saying? He got the proof right here.
Let me finish reading this. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself maketh intercessions for us with groanings which cannot be uttered.
And look, and that's why they've been fighting over Jerusalem for 1,000 years. Ain't nobody fighting over no Egypt. And they got pyramids, but they still ain't fighting over Egypt. They fighting over Jerusalem, bro, the Holy Land. That's what they fighting over. They fighting over that Holy Land because that's, they know that's where it's at.
Ain't no battle.
Every time, there's ever been a God, he's been killing in his name.
That's good, though. What's up, bro? She don't even know, you know.
Talk to your grandfather against mission? You're about a surgeon?
Yeah, I heard about it. You know anything about it?
Surgeon?
No, like how he's on.
Oh, no, I don't know how he's on. He don't want nobody to come over. This is what Nigel told me.
Man, King
I'd rather,
David.
I'd rather know than believe.
What they don't want, you know, I'm gonna hit you with something. What they don't want you to know is that King David set up a global empire. He controlled the whole earth, especially in the Solomon. They had outposts all around the world in Japan, North America, South America. Hey, they was coming into North and South America getting resources and taking it back to the Holy Land.
Yeah, chill.
But they tell you that King Solomon was the richest king that ever lived.
1998.
Of course the devil
is 2017.
That's what the devil does.
And my birthday ain't until June.
That's what that is. Because he don't want you to give people that spirit.
Concept.
Oh, it's a concept, dog.
Got some kryptonite for
you. Come on, I got some kryptonite for
you. You just straight up, man.
Anybody from any reputable company.
No, actually, like, there is.
Show their identification on it.
That's why the Christians use
that. Well, I mean, you got his number, don't
based
you?
On
yeah.
Text him like, hey, this is Cleveland. How you
whenever
been?
You do Coptic Christianity,
he's going to be leaving soon.
That's what I'm saying.
You got a traditional religion that's been practiced 20,000 years.
Why you think they killed him?
That's the highlight of my day.
20,000 years. I'm just talking about this right here. 10,000 years. I mean, without no mixture. So why would they automatically just change? They're called abruptly like that. True indeed.
I mean, it's because it gives you
the polytheism, you know what I mean?
Gives you an insight of religion.
You're going back to ancient chemistry.
It depends on what you mean.
So, mind you, how you
been?
How was I?
Obviously, the programming technology is better.
Well, what do you mean by better? Because if we end up in a nuclear holocaust, somebody's going to know how to fix the marriage and establish
freaking
cars.
No, all around the world. We had a more established society.
Technology
did not establish society, at least not completely.
Obviously.
But it definitely accelerated human growth.
I want to see the
puppets.
I mean, obviously, servers, though, are the best thing to, like,
I mean, it might not be as urgent, but it does seem a lot more.
When you read about the story of the Mount Sinai,
instead of the thing is, like, I did actually like, want to do eyeball technology because they wanted to have that. So
he came down in that chariot, the so-called UFO, and parked on top of that mountain. And then he led the Israelites through the Red Sea.
I mean, it seemed a lot more lucrative to do because I wanted to learn how to not get
that's how Egypt got destroyed.
That's right. You still standing
there. So it was a UFO that split the water.
I'm going to keep
split the UFO.
They actually split the sea. That actually happened. That's why all the nations feared the Israelites.
And
they know the power that's
there. I can find my notes.
What notes are you talking about?
I'm talking about my...
Oh, you want to share my auto? I definitely plan on becoming a master technician one day and possibly owning my own shop and doing it with tens of that's what it is for me, like managing an auto shop, this and that, you know what I'm saying? I got the same number of projects, you know what I mean?
What was the council 9605?
That's what they called it. Valentine.
I'm gonna hit you. What was the council not see your cousin?
It's
1611 King James. When the King James Bible first came out, there was 81 books. It wasn't until the 1800s when they took some books out.
I was born Father's Day. My dad died 7 years
in the Council of Nicaea wasn't about none of that. The Council of Nicaea was about the heresy of Arianism. Because they, the Arians got it right, and they said that the Arians said that the son is not the father.
Like my dad was born in November.
That's the truth. But that's what the council. Go look it up. The council of Nicaea was about Arianism.
I understand the knowledge. You also understand
that November 14th,
like an older
concept.
Aloxiana.
That's born from.
A
mother not having a father.
Who's that in the Bible?
It's not in the Bible. Dad died the day after his birth. On the 15th, November 13th, of 2000, my mom
got a lot of
started the divorce application.
November
12th. I got evicted from my first apartment.
But I'm going to the book and tell you.
Wow. That's bad shit happened.
I'm surprised.
Hey, how you doing? The
book is locked up. You get the same story in the book. 10,000,
20,000
years. Once you do that, at that point in time, the book that you have standing no longer has
Let me read this.
This is Ecclesiastes. Listen up. This is Ecclesiastes 12 and 12. And further, by these, my son, be admonished of many books there is no end. And much study is a weariness of the flesh. So all that matters, man, above the world. It has nothing to do with
the
young
one
here.
What, you get on the 10th?
We already know
you go in the book. Then you want to go to chapter 1. What you want?
In the beginning, the God. I'm gonna read a scripture for you. Isaiah 34 and 16. Seek ye out of the book of Yahweh and read. No one of these shall fail, none shall want her mate. The Lord says that his, in Hebrews, his rewalk is in you. The Lord's breath is in
you. I used to talk to God. You know what I mean? And I would answer for myself. You know what I'm saying? I say, Father. Right. And in my own head, I say,
yes,
my son. Hey, then I carry on to the conversation. Then I had to tell myself, you wake your dumb ass up and realize that you know that you answer for God.
No, she was just telling me some really, really fucked up shit while you guys were talking.
She looked cool though.
You can get a regular joke to church, right? So you get a regular joke off to church, right? You get a mason to go to the church, right? Now you get one word with two separate understandings. That right there tells you that it's a deeper meaning. If you don't know the knowledge of that interpretation, then you don't understand what's going on.
That's crazy. You gotta be crazy to believe that. That's not knowledge. That's that nation of Islam.
It was translated from the Hebrew.
It said Moses was learning all the ways of the Egyptians. You know what I mean? So when you say all, that don't leave no room for excuse.
What sense does that make? Moses learned from the Egyptians.
Why did he say, let my people go?
Why did Moses flee Egypt?
He killed the Egyptians.
Why did he flee Egypt? For murder.
Because the niggas going northward.
He left Egypt for murder.
It was no different.
Then, he seen two Hebrew brothers fighting each other, and he said, y'all ain't supposed to be fighting each other.
No, he seen an Egyptian slave master whooping a Hebrew.
And he said, well, how can you tell us this when you flee Egypt for...
Hebrews 11, 24. By faith, Moses, who was 22 years, refused
He refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter.
He would rather to suffer a piece of the people of God than get you a Jordan.
I'll be back, guys.
No? Who the people are?
Are you guys still debating?
No, people. Oh,
and then supposedly, this supposedly, 80 years later, he got supposedly got some tablets that said, "Thou shalt not kill."
Tablets.
You know, he was the word for murder and kill.
In the Bible, it's 18.
It's two words.
It's actually 613 stone tablets. It only shows supposedly coming down from the mountain.
Actually, he went up there once, brought the tablets down, saw the Israelites worshiping a golden tablet. The Egyptian guy, he got so pissed that he broke the first set of tablets. Then he took the bull, the Apis bull, crushed him to pieces, and said, "The hell with your bull," broke it, and said, "The hell with your Egyptian bull." Put it in the water and made the Israelites drink it with a punch. And even say he's whooping the ass.
That's right.
They beat the hell out of him, bro.
Yeah, that Moses must be strong.
Moses wasn't playing.
He was strong when he was in the ball. You know what I'm saying?
He was
613 stone tablets.
No.
Hey, it was the whole front.
No, that's 613. Oh, cool. But the Ten Commandments, though. But when you read the scriptures, the Ten Commandments was written by the Most High's hand himself. Like they, you know what I'm saying? The Most High actually wrote that with him himself. And that's what they kept in the Ark of the Covenant. You know what I'm saying?
Let me read this real quick. This is Exodus 11:7. Exodus 11:7. But against any of the children of Israel shall not a dog lose his tongue, against man or beast, that he may know how that the Lord doth put a difference between the Egyptians
and Egyptians. For the
Egyptians, they
have mites.
This is right here, 666. That's the mark of the beast.
The mark of the beast?
It's the mark of the beast.
Nah. That's six protons, six electrons.
That's
the fire, boy.
I told you.
At least, I give him credit. At least he ain't talking about mad in the rap lyrics.
This is Ecclesiastes 5:1.
Better is pronouncing Christian.
Chose to make a new name.
Where did Egyptians come from? Let's question that. Where did Egyptians come from?
Egyptians came out of Nubia. They came from the south. Okay. And they went up to the northeast and west.
Okay, so who's the Egyptians? Somebody was born in Israel. Who's a nation there? Who was? Who was it?
Here you go. Galatians 4:26. Listen. But Jerusalem, which is above, is free, which is the mother of us all. Not Egypt.
Like I said, that's why nobody fighting over Egypt. Everybody fighting over the Holy Land, not Egypt.
At this moment,
Jesus pioneered.
All throughout history. They've been waiting.
Jesus is the pioneer. Listen. The pioneer, but I'm thinking about the Bible.
Okay, bro.
Hey, Bruce?
That's probably check.
See, the Greeks called him Horus.
Well, I know, man.
You gotta go. Well, what did his people call him?
You know what the Canaanites called him? The owl. You know what we call him? Satan. The Lord of the Flies. That's what his name is, the Lord of the Flies. Baal's above. That's Baal's above, bro.
Suhan.
No, that really is Baal's above. Because he got different names. You know, the ancient Sumerians called him Marduk. You know, the Greeks called him Zeus. You know what I'm saying? The Vikings called
say
him
Jesus is Spanish. Hey, Zeus.
Exactly.
Hey, Zeus.
Exactly.
Goddamn Zeus.
We know that.
Let me read this.
You know what I mean?
You're right.
Is it a coincidence when you could take Jesus and put him right next to Serapis and they look identical?
But even Zeus is actually Dios. In the ancient Greek, it's Dios. Which means two. You know what I mean?
Zechariah.
But it's not the Lord. The Lord is Yahushua.
Zechariah 14:9. Listen, man. And the Lord shall be king over all the earth. In that day shall there be one Lord, and his name one.
The scriptures say, study to show thyself approved. So it's not given to the slothful man.
You know what I mean? You gotta come with the original. You can't come with some hearsay.
You
gotta
come
with
the original.
You got the original book. Yeah, whatever the fuck you got. You got the original book.
They had to write one picture, bro. That would take them a week just to write one sentence.
Yeah, I can teach you that.
I studied hieroglyphs, bro. You know what I'm saying? That shit don't even profit.
Who's your Egyptian guy? They don't.
Quote some Egyptian scripture. Oh, the seed and the sperm and the sky with the goddess and the different man.
God that he's showing light right now. That's the sun.
Wait a minute.
You know what I mean? The God that you talk about, I can go in that book to show where he's so referencing himself as being the sun.
The sun's a machine. The sun is something the Lord created.
I can show in the Bible he calls himself. He references himself as the sun.
Of course.
If I look at somebody who worship the sun, that would sustain his life. If that sun gone, we all dead.
Of course. But who put it there?
I mean, more than a man. Then I can respect that.
Yeah, he put it there. They don't talk to
you. When you prove to me the God that you talk to is actually, when it's an eyewitness account, everybody can look at God at one time and say, oh, we all hear the same thing. And that's
that? Where's whatever? These retarded guys. You know that bottom.
Yeah, where's Osiris at, bro? Where he at?
Solomon 13:1.
Actually, Osiris was a real person. He was actually Mitzrayim. He was the founder of the Egyptians. And then after he died, it was a common custom that he was to deify him. So, Osiris was the actual king, the actual lived, that real person, and they deified him.
You Greek?
Huh?
Are you Greek?
No, I'm an Israelite.
An Israelite. That's why you call him Osiris.
It don't matter.
His real name is Osiris.
I know that. But that's not his real name. His real name was Mitzrayim. That was Mitzrayim. So what's Isis's real name, right? Hold on.
Aset.
So where do you get Isis Ra'el from? If that's not the real name.
Because that's what the Greeks called it.
Say.
You know what I mean? The Greeks changed the name.
Got it.
You know, just like in English, they changed the name from Mary, Joseph, and Jesus.
Now, that's why I'm
saying. They changed.
So when we're dealing with the Hebrew, all the myths fall apart. Go ahead.
Wisdom of Solomon 13:1. Surely vain, you're talking about the son of the God or whatever. Surely vain are all men by nature who are ignorant of God and cannot out of the good things that are seen know him, that is. Neither by considering the works did they acknowledge the work master, but these are the fire, the wind, or the swift air of the serpent stars, or the violent water, or the lights of heaven.
Can you read Genesis?
Yeah, that's why all the pagans had their Poseidon.
I can see the sun.
You cut no sun.
I can see it too.
And I can understand the sun is what sustains life.
It's just a spirit.
I can't see the God you're talking about.
The air sustains
too.
I can't see the God you're talking about.
Spirit.
When you prove that this God actually exists.
He's trying to rub it in. He's trying to make him hear it, man.
When you prove that this God exists,
but we only proved it through the scriptures, though.
If you can't, if you show me in the book,
but we
I can find
you
anything
in the scriptures.
You know what I'm saying?
We
wrote that book when it was time for God shit. They wrote that shit on me.
Listen to that.
My God ordained me to come in to change and take over. That's what he wanted God to
say.
Time for them to wrote that shit.
This is just proof my point. Please ask your father, Lord, keep thy foot when thou goest to the house of the Most High. Be more ready to hear than to give a sacrifice of food, and let consider nothing that you eat. Be not rash with thy mouth, and let not thy heart be hasty to utter anything before the Most High. And we up here about the scripture. You even open the Bible up and start reading.
True, true indeed.
So
but
come
on,
read
the proof is that
listen, man.
A question that still was.
We let you speak, but you ain't letting us speak.
I heard.
Listen, man.
Hey, that's it.
That's Hayward right there in that tornado, right?
Or the violent water, or the lights of heaven, the moon, the sun.
That's the proof we have.
Yeah, let me ask, what are the stars?
Genesis 1 yourself.
What are stars?
You read Genesis 1 yourself.
What are they?
Stars of light. Stars of the gas forms.
Can you prove that, right? Can you prove that, right?
Where the sun is the gas.
Yeah, what's the sun? Yeah.
Prove that it's light energy.
So you worship gas now?
Worship gas? I'd rather look at the sun, you know what I mean? That which I know sustains life, you know what I mean? Because without that motherfucker,
sun worship.
You got sun worship. Verify from the man, you know what I mean? Because how this book come into your hand? This book come into your hand come from another man. If it didn't come into your hand, you wouldn't know nothing about it. But that sun is always going to be there. That sun always going to be there.
That's the Illuminati shit. It is. The rising sun is a symbol of the Illuminati. It's on the seal of Ohio. That's what, go ahead.
This is basically, with whose beauty have they been invited to
took them and guided them, let them know how much better the good of them is for the person of their beauty has created them. But they will astonish at the power of virtue.
Oh, it's not good.
They can be astonished at that. Let them understand by them how much mightier he is that made them. For by the greatness and beauty of the creatures from virtue of all, the maker of them sin. But yet, for this they are less to blame for their previous but being versus the works, they search ability and believe their sight. Sight stars and sun. Because the lights are beautiful that are seen. My feet, neither are they hardened. If they were able to know so much, know so much harder.
The stars.
Okay. You know so much that they can aim at the Lord.
My definition is not sooner
find out the Lord.
My definition.
It's like this. Really, look. It's like this, bro. The Most High, the ultimate scientist. Right? He's the ultimate engineer. So when a clockmaker makes a clock, he makes a good clock like a Swiss. What's the Rolex? You make a Rolex. It don't just works on energy, right? And that motherfucker don't break. It just keeps on ticking. That's what the Most High did. He said that. A rock gets us out. But also keeps you warm, keeps you light. And then the moon gives off light too. The moon gives off its own light.
Its own
moon. Its own moon. It don't come from the sun.
No.
But you can see, the Lord, the ultimate clockmaker. He created this whole machine, and it don't go off course. It don't stop. It just keeps on ticking, just like that Rolex. You know what I'm saying? Think about it. The Most High, the ultimate.
The sun comes, then the sunlight.
It was obvious.
It ain't like
the white man says, if the sun just came out of nothing in the Big Bang. Somebody created it. It had to happen. Somebody created it.
Oh, yeah. What did yesterday? I think yesterday there was
I bet you I can make a bowl out of the clay.
Yeah,
so there you go. Where do people come from?
Always exist.
It depends on the people we talk about.
I mean, if you go deep into genetics, I understand the 6 DNA strands, 9 DNA strands, I understand all of them.
You understand DNA? You understand DNA?
Nobody understands.
How is that possible that the science world?
The scientists don't understand.
The scientists don't know.
What's the 23rd string? What's the 24th string? It's supposed to start. What is it? What is it though? Making a mini book, so it's, you know,
that comes out of God. I mean, he's the only one.
That was Jason.
That's why they got on the rappers over there. They got style over there.
Oh, they got all kind of pastors.
You got some fine ass.
You have a pastor in Donna. Nah, I ain't trying to go there. I would love to go. I got a pastor over there feeding his congregation multiple. I got the video.
Wow.
I got the video.
Yeah, all the Ghana, Mali, all them niggas were like, what was that King of Richest King movie?
Musa.
He was an Israelite.
He comes out of Mali.
He was an Israelite. He was
trying to come out of Mali.
Out of Mali, yeah. Right. He was an Israelite.
Israelites, like I said, I was going to read to you in Exodus 11 and 7. More scattered, but you don't just read it first.
Yeah, the Israel got scattered, man. That's part of it. Actually, Israel's the most numerous people on the planet. More than billions of Israelites.
You wanted to take the other way around. That's the truth.
We can't let me figure it out.
It's too late.
You can run me 427. Listen, man.
Hey, there's no too late.
Most of them made it great. Moses has made a great nation. And the Lord shall and the Lord shall scatter you among the nations, and ye shall be left. Get up, Acts 2:1. And ye shall be left few in number among the heathen, but the Lord shall keep you.
That was then, but now we are
wrong.
Hey, y'all done did the old scoot down. They done migrated 500 feet. That's like we over here dancing.
Acts 2:1, it says, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place, and suddenly there came a sound of heaven, like a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house with us. It appeared to them, clothed in tongues like as a fire, and it sat upon each of them. All filled with those spirits. Get the tongues, as the Spirit gave them utterance. And they were dwelling at Jerusalem, Jews, devout men, out of every nation,
out of heaven.
Now were they.
I'm going to hit you with something. All them Greeks that you hear that Paul was talking to, those was the Israelites. That's why you see the Greek alphabet, it looked just like Hebrew. It is Hebrew. You know what I'm saying?
I mean,
Listen.
Now when they was voiced abroad, the multitudes came together and were confounded because that every man heard that speak in his own language, and they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, behold, now all these men were speaking
Galileans,
and how hear we every man his own tongue when we were born, Britannians and Medians, Elamites, and the dwellers of Mesopotamia.
Yeah, we did. Jake said Mesopotamia. He'd tell you Israel got carried off to slavery in Babylon. And a lot of them stayed there, you know what I'm saying? Man, there's Jakes everywhere, all over the earth. Even Ireland. There's Jakes in Ireland. That's why the original name of Ireland was Hibernia, from Hebrew. You know what I'm saying? Even Spain was called Iberia, from Hebrew. Iberia, Siberia. You see the word Hebrew all over the place. You know what I'm saying? There's Jakes everywhere. Go ahead.
And in Judea, Plutonius in Asia, from Libya, Lydia, Egypt, and the parts of Libya.
Libya? Man, they tell you that the Israelites was famous for living in Carthage. You know what I'm saying?
That's a bad scripture. Everywhere, name all kind of heathen places.
Yeah, the North American Indians were Israelites.
That's right.
They came over here roughly 2,700 years ago. That's why they had all them pyramids over here in America. You know what I'm saying?
Kemet.
The Bible tells you about Kemet. It's called Kam in the Hebrew. It means burnt.
Ethiopia.
That's why everything.
Like Ethiopia.